testimony and a frank discussion about how to resolve this. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you very much, Mr. Klein. And now we'll hear from Mrs. Capito, West Virginia.
1 minute.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to thank you for convening this hearing this morning. As I was on my way to work this morning into the office, the first person I encountered looked at me and said, "Something isn't right here," in reference to the recent news of the AIG bonuses. And to be honest, I couldn't agree more. When this body first considered the proposal that would become the TARP program, I and others expressed significant concerns that we were moving too quickly, there was too much risk for the taxpayer, and too little oversight. News accounts from this week only reconfirm what many of us said from the beginning. There was not adequate understanding or transparency surrounding these dollars. All across the nation, American families and small businesses are tightening budgets, cutting back on costs, and making tough decisions. And the recent news of these bonuses has just added an insult to the prudence of these small businesses and families that are making difficult decisions every day. Whether we like it or not, or whether they like it or not, the companies that have received TARP or plan are under intense scrutiny, understandably. The light is shining brightly on their actions, and it is my hope we can resolve the current economic challenges so taxpayers are no longer on the hook for this type of excess. I would like to thank the witnesses for being here today and look forward to the testimony. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Ms. Capito. And now we'll hear from Mr. Peters of Michigan. 1 minute.